Hello, everyone. I hope you are weathering these last weeks of the semester well. Keep in mind that you're almost through. If you followed instructions, you will have submitted the final draft of your process essay before the deadline on Friday night and read an example of our next essay over the weekend. The example compare and contrast essay looked at the similarities and differences between two different potential careers. Your own compare and contrast essay will do the same thing. The prompt is this: write 750 to 1250 words comparing and contrasting two fields in which you might work in the future. You'll need to identify two jobs that interest you, then choose two or three points of comparison, such as hours, salary, education requirements, licensing requirements, flexibility, alignment with your interests, stuff like that, before finally researching how each job stacks up against the other. You should cite four or more sources in MLA format, including in-text citations and a works cited page to support your analysis. If you don't have at least four sources and a works cited page, I won't look at your essay draft. If your final draft lacks these things, it's a minimum 10 points off. The research aspect of this is the whole reason we're doing it, so please make sure to get that part done. If you're confused about what these citations are or what they look like, don't worry. I have some more resources, videos mostly, coming up next. These will explain everything you need to know about citations. The assigned reading in your compact reader book from last week also covers this information. So you've encountered explanations of MLA citations both via assigned reading and assigned videos. So if you've done all of your assigned reading and viewing activities, you shouldn't have any trouble. Reference the example paper in last weekend's reading if you aren't sure about this paper. You can see what someone else did to give yourself some inspiration for where to go. If you're still confused, I encourage you to make an appointment with a tutor at the Student Success Center in the library. Remember, that's free. Of course, for the rough draft, I want proper MLA formatting. This means 12-point Times New Roman font with a title and page numbers. If you forget, I'll expect you to send me a fixed draft via email before I give you feedback. We're in week 11 now, so this should be part of your writing routine at this point. On an unrelated note, registration for next semester's classes is also now open, and I am also a student advisor. So if you have enjoyed my kind heart and bubbly personality in class, feel free to shoot me an email to get registered for next semester's classes. If you'd rather die than work with me any more than you have to, there is another student advisor named Jeremy Erlbach that you can reach out to. But you should talk to one of us pretty soon to make sure that you get the classes you want. Cool? Cool. Good luck, you guys. I know that this part of the semester is very stressful for all of you, and I appreciate your continued hard work and dedication in my class. Really, I know I ask a lot, so thanks. And good luck.